Are you ready to take your SwiftUI skills to the next level? In this video, we pit NavigationStack against NavigationCoordinator in an epic battle to determine which navigation method reigns supreme. Discover the strengths and weaknesses of each approach, see them in action with real-world examples, and find out which one is the best fit for your next app project. Don't miss out on this crucial insight that would revolutionize your development process. Watch now to find out who wins. I am using Navigation Coordinator in all of my clients' apps. Go ahead and check out the link in the description if you want to hire me. I could build out your business app. Rebeloper.com/hire-us. Now, this is the second part of the tutorial series of NavigationStack versus Navigation Coordinator. The previous one, we built out a whole application inside with NavigationStack and Sheets. And this is what we got. Let me just build and run. Go ahead and check out the link in the description for the whole playlist if you want to take a look at that to better understand what we built out here. But basically what we have is an authentication part where we just log in basically. Then we have a tab view, and when it appears, we have a deep link all the way to the item view, purchase view, and cart view. And in the middle of this navigation, we have a sheet. So let me just show you. We're fetching the items. Here's the sheet, and we presented the cart. If you blinked, you missed it, but you know, take a look at the previous one. And also, we are going to build this out today with the help of Navigation Coordinator, and you will see how easy it is. You know, the previous video was a pain. Let's pop to root so we can see that it works. Yes, this is also really hard to add into SwiftUI applications. And yeah, go ahead and take a look at the code, the previous video. Also, while we go through the code and modify it, you will see how cumbersome it is to set all of this up, but not with Navigation Coordinator. A 30% discount link is in the description if you want to check out that one. Small businesses should build an app for the App Store to boost visibility, enhance customer engagement, and increase sales. An app provides a direct, personalized channel to customers, essential for staying competitive in today's mobile-driven market. Hire me at rebeloper.com/hire-us to build a professional, high-quality app tailored to your business needs, leveraging my expertise and innovative approach to turn your vision into reality. So first things first, we want to add the library into our project. Okay, so yeah, of course you want to do that. And then we want to go and set it up. This will be kind of the hardest part, but bear with me, it's relatively simple. Let's create a new file. And we need to have an extension on the destination. So we are going to call this destination plus. Here we have it. We want to import SwiftUI, and then we want to have an extension, as I told you, on a destination. Now, destination is basically something, it's inside the Navigation Coordinator. So we want to set up our views right over here in one place so we can access them and use them whenever we want in our navigation. So we're going to have this static let auth for the auth view, but this is just the declaration. So we just want to have this destination. It's just a destination. We're going to link it with the auth view later on. So let's duplicate this a few more times, and let's have this as a feed, and then profile, and then we have the item, the purchase, and finally the cart. Okay. Go ahead and check out the previous video if you don't understand which views do what. But anyway, if you watch this video, you will understand too. So then the final step is that we want to adhere to the view protocol on this destination. Therefore, we want to create our body. And then for each of these cases, we want to give that particular view. So we just go with a switch statement, switch self, and then we have a lot of cases. Let's see if it's just going to have auto completion. Well, not really. So we are going to go through the cases manually. So case dot auth, we are just going to present the auth view. And because this is kind of the root view, we want to remove the back button. Automatically, it's added to all of the views when we set this up. So we just say destination and then set this to true. Okay, another case is the second one is the feed. Again, this is a root view, so we just go feed view dot destination and set that to true. I'm not going to spell it out. Navigation bar back button hidden. It's a long one. So case dot profile. Again, it's kind of the root view, profile view, and then append this destination with that set to true. Okay, these are kind of the root views, but anyway, you may use them as not root views, but remember the back button will be removed. If you are going to use this, just change this to false or just remove the property altogether. So another case is the item. So on the item, we are just presenting the item view. And in the previous episode, we just set this item view up with the item. We're going to remove it, but for now, so we don't have any warnings, I'm just going to set up a dummy item right over here. The most important part is that we want to add this destination view modifier over there. Okay, let's have another case for the purchase. Let's add our purchase view right over here. Again, we want to initialize this dummy item and should pop to root is just set to an empty view. We are going to remove it anyway. Most important part is that we want to have this as destination. And finally, a case of cart. Again, we are going to have item in it. We are going to remove this as we change the code. Most important part again, that we have this destination. And that's it. We want to set up the default. Default value, empty view. So on the default, we just want to set up an empty view. We're not going to navigate there anyway. So that's our destination plus. Now let's refactor our code. So first thing, we want to go into our app controller, and we are not going to need these navigation paths and the Boolean value. We are just going to store our selected item right over here. So selected item is of type item and optional. So we are just going to store the item that we are basically navigating with. We're not going to pass it along as we did previously. I'm not going to comment this out maybe later on in the tutorial because, but they're going to have a lot of warnings, but we are going to remove them sooner or later. Content view. Right over here, the tabs view is basically not a navigation coordinator. Think of the navigation coordinator as a navigation stack with sheets incorporated also. They don't really work with tabs views. You want to set a navigation coordinator route, a route navigation, as a separate tab. And you will do that in just a second. So right over here, tabs view, we leave it. And on the auth view, let me just comment it out. And let's set up a route. A navigation route with dot auth. We're not going to navigate in the auth view. We're not going to do that. But it's good to be as with the other setup. Okay, so let's go to the tabs view right over here. As you can see, we have this navigation stack right over here. It's okay, but it's quite cumbersome. So let's replace this. I'm going to comment this out. And let's have a navigation route with a feed. And all I have to do is just add the tab item. Let me just comment this out, copy it. So let's paste that tab item over there. And I'm just going to copy this part out and add also our profile. It's really nice that it's just auto-completing right over there. And set the system name to person. And that's it. As you can see, it's much, much nicer. Let's go to the feed view. Yes, on the feed view, we added our list. And now we want to actually remove the navigation destination. We are not going to use that one. Also, remove how we are navigating. And let's comment out also the deep link. So What we want to do is access the navigation. Therefore, we are going to do that with an environment. So Earth environment. So Earth environment dot navigation. As you can see, it's just popping up. Private var. And I'm going to call it navigation. Great. So it's as simple as that. We don't need to set up navigation destinations, all of that stuff. We are just going to say on the app controller, app controller dot selected, come on, selected item equals this item. Okay, so we moved our data into the selected item. And then we just say navigation dot push. Push. And what do we want to push? Well, we want to push our item. So the item view that's representing. And it's that simple. Let me just see what's going on over here. So next, we want to remove the item from the item view. We no longer need it because, you know, we just set it up on the selection. So now that we removed that, let me just clean up the code right over here. Let's just do that. And let's do some cleanup on the item view itself. So what we want is the navigation. So navigation. Let me just copy this out and paste it in there. And now that we don't have the item, we want to access it from the app controller. Selected item. That's optional. And selected item, and let's give a default value right over there. Okay, also we no longer need the sheet right over here, so I'm just going to comment it out. And on the purchase, we are just going to use the navigation dot push, and we are going to push the purchase, and this time we are going to use a sheet, so the type will be dot sheet. By default it's link, the type now it's just sheet. Now this could be fixed, this error could be fixed by adding at main actor, or you could just put them put it into a task and an await. So let me just do that. Task and then await. There we go. Okay, so yeah, now let's clean up the purchase view because, you know, we no longer need the item and also the should pop to root. Let's just remove all of that. Instead of this miss, we are going to use the navigation again. Let's go navigation. And I'm going to copy out the selected item. So we are getting a little bit faster there. There we go. We no longer need this navigation destination. And also, now we are going to go to the cart view. So navigation.push and then just cart. Simple as that. No, selected item is still like that. Again, let me just have at main actor right over here. You could just do the task as we did previously. And now we can clean up on the destination. So the purchase view, let me just remove all of that. There we go. And finally, on the cart view, let's remove all of this. We want to have the navigation. There we go. We also want to have access to our app controller. So I'm going to copy that out, cart view. Let's just paste it in there. And let me just copy again the selected item text. There we go. And now we want to dismiss. So let me just copy, comment this out, and let's dismiss. And it couldn't be easier. Again, let's just have a task and then await navigation dot pop to root. Pop to root. And this simple one. So just pop to root. There are multiple ones, and pop to root and popping in general. There's a lot of variations over there. Go ahead and check out the link in the description for the product navigation coordinator. We have a 30% discount link over there. And you may take a look at all the use cases. So it just pop to root. And that's just it. Let me just clean up the destination again. So right over there, and let's hit Command B so we make sure that we did not miss anything. Let's see what's going on right over here. We want to make this as a small n for the navigation. There we go. Okay, so this should work. And let's just test out basically the pop to root right now. So we are going to navigate to wherever. Let's just click on Apple. It's just presenting it. Purchase. Just going to go all the way up. Now add to cart. Again, a link type of navigation. And then pop to root. It's just going to go all the way down to root. Simple as that. We're just one. And by the way, whichever you would do this, let me just, for example, on the purchase view, or rather in the item view where we have our sheet, let's just set this to link. And you will see the difference. It's amazing. So we just log in. Let's just wait for this. Apple, purchase. Again, we navigate. Add to cart again. Pop to root. It's just going to go all the way down to the feet in one animation, might I say. It's really, really amazing. So let's just go back to the sheet because yeah, this is more interesting. And now let's add that deep link because, you know, we just commented this out, but we never added the deep link that we actually need. It's kind of the reverse of the pop to root. So let's create a task right over there. And it couldn't be simpler. We just go await navigation.push. And the first one, we are going to push the item. Okay, let's duplicate this. And we are going to push the purchase of type sheet.sheet. And then we are going to, let me just duplicate this again. Push the cart. But this time around, we are just going to leave it as a link. And it's as simple as that. Three easy lines. Readable and maintainable, and of course you may change it to your likes. 1, 2, 3, we are there, and then we can just pop back to root. Now Navigation Coordinator is available for 5 people at a 30% discount. Go ahead and check out the link in the description. And just so you know, I'm using all of this, the Navigation Coordinator, in my own project that I built for customers. If you want to hire me to build you an app, I do usually business apps. Go ahead and check out rebeloper.com/hireus. The link is again in the description.